Dear students, welcome to e-Shikshana program. In today's class, I will be considering another continuous probability distribution, namely exponential probability distribution. Exponential distribution is a continuous probability distribution for which the probability density function PDF is given by f of x is equal to alpha into e power minus alpha x for x greater than or equal to 0 and 0 elsewhere where alpha is positive. So we can easily notice that f of x is greater than or equal to 0 and integral from minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is equal to 1. Exponential probability distribution may be used for random variables such as the time between arrivals at a car wash, the time required to load a truck, the distance between major defects in a highway, and so on. The graph of the probability density function of exponential distribution slopes downward to the right from its maximum at x is equal to 0. Mean and variance of exponential probability distribution. So by definition, for a continuous random variable, mean e of x is given by e of x is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity x into f x dx. So from the definition of f of x, this can be written as minus infinity to 0 x into f of x dx plus 0 to infinity x into f of x dx. In this interval, f of x is 0, so this integral vanishes, so we are left with the second integral 0 to infinity x into f of x dx. So in this interval, f of x is given to be alpha into e power minus alpha x, therefore e of x is equal to integral 0 to infinity x into alpha e power minus alpha x dx. So alpha is constant, so that can be taken outside the integral, and integrating x into e power minus alpha x with respect to x from 0 to infinity using general rule of integration by parts, we obtain alpha into first function x into integration of second function e power minus alpha x by minus alpha minus differentiation of the first function, that is 1, into integration of this e power minus alpha x divided by minus alpha into another minus alpha, that is plus alpha square. So this gets terminated here because u dash is constant. So this is evaluated at 0 and infinity. When x is infinity, e power minus infinity is 0. So this is 0 minus 0, that is 0 minus the lower limit. When x is 0, first term is 0 minus e power 0 is 1, 1 by alpha square. If we simplify this, we get alpha into minus into minus, that is plus alpha into 1 by alpha square. So cancelling 1 alpha, we get 1 by alpha. So mean of exponential distribution is 1 by alpha. Variance sigma square is equal to ex square minus e of x the whole square. So e of x is already determined, e of x, that is mean, given to be 1 by alpha. So we need to find e of x square. So e of x square is integral minus infinity to plus infinity x square into f of x dx. So from the definition, by the definition of f of x, so this can be written as sum of two integrals. So integral minus infinity to 0 x square f x dx plus integral 0 to infinity x square f x dx. So this is equal to in this interval f x is 0, so therefore this integral vanishes, so therefore we are left with only one integral from 0 to infinity x square f of x dx. In this integral, in this interval, f of x is alpha into e power minus alpha x, so we get e of x square is equal to integral 0 to infinity x square into alpha e power minus alpha x dx. So alpha is constant, so writing outside the integral, so this is equal to alpha into 0 to infinity x square e power minus alpha x dx. So integrating this by parts, this integration integral by parts using general rule of integration by parts, So this can be written as alpha into, so this is the first function, this is the second function, x square integration of e power minus alpha x, e power minus alpha x by minus alpha minus alternate sign plus minus. So differentiation of x square is 2x into integration of this e power minus alpha x divided by minus alpha into another minus alpha, that is minus alpha whole square or plus alpha square, then minus to plus. In differentiation of 2x is 2, integration of this quantity e power minus alpha x divided by minus alpha square into another minus alpha, that is minus alpha cube or minus alpha cube. So this gets terminated here because u double dash, this is u dash 2x, u double dash is 2. So this gets terminated and this is evaluated at 0 and infinity. So alpha into, when upper limit is substituted, e power minus infinity is 0, 0, 0, so this is 0, minus, minus the lower limit, when x is 0, this is the first term is 0, second term is 0, so yet minus alpha cube is minus alpha cube, so minus, this is 1, e power 0 is 1, so minus 2 divided by alpha cube. So when we simplify this, we get alpha into minus, that is plus, 2 divided by alpha cube, that is alpha into 2 divided by alpha cube. So cancelling 1 alpha, we get 2 by alpha square. So e of x square is 2 by alpha square. So substituting in the formula of variance, sigma square is equal to e x square minus e of x the whole square, we get sigma square variance is equal to 2 by alpha square minus 1 by alpha whole square, that is 1 by alpha square. So simplifying this, we get sigma square is equal to 2 minus 1 by alpha square or 1 by alpha square. So therefore, standard deviation is 1 by alpha. Let us consider the problems. Problem number 1. If x is an exponential variate with mean 3, find probability of x greater than 1, probability of x less than 3. Okay. So given that x is an exponential variate with mean 3. So mean is given to be 3. So first in the solution part, first let us write the probability density function PDF of exponential distribution. That is f of x is equal to alpha e power minus alpha x, x greater than or equal to 0, and elsewhere it is 0, alpha is positive. So given that, we know that mean is 1 by alpha, mean is equal to 1 by alpha. Therefore, mean is given to be 3, so 3 is equal to 1 by alpha, so therefore alpha is 1 by 3. Substituting for alpha in f of x, we get f of x is equal to 1 by 3 e power minus x by 3, alpha is 1 by 3, that is minus alpha x minus x by 3, x greater than or equal to 0, 0 elsewhere, where alpha is positive. So that is 1 by 3 is positive. Okay. So first question, probability of x greater than 1. Probability of x greater than 1. So P of probability of x greater than 1 can be written as 1 to infinity of f of x dx. 1 to infinity f of x dx. So 1 to infinity is part of 0 less than or equal to x less than infinity. So therefore, f of x is 1 by 3 e power minus x by 3 in the interval 1 to infinity. So therefore, this is equal to integral 1 to infinity 1 by 3 e power minus x by 3 dx is equal to, so integrating e power minus x by 3, that is integration of e power ax is equal to e power ax divided by a. So here a is minus 1 by 3, a is minus 1 by 3. So writing, taking 1 by 3 outside the integral, so 1 by 3 integration of e power minus x by 3 e power minus x by 3 divided by minus 1 by 3 evaluated at 1 and infinity. So this is, so cancelling this 3 can cancel, it can take minus sign outside, so minus e power minus x by 3 evaluated at 1 and infinity. So this is equal to, when x is infinity, e power minus infinity is 0, so e power minus infinity is 0, minus when x is 1, e power minus 1 by 3. So if you take minus sign inside, this will become e power plus e power minus 1 by 3. If we use the calculator and simplify and find out the value, we get the numerical value 0.7165. So probability of x greater than 1 is equal to 0.7165. The second problem, probability of x less than 3. So this is equal to minus infinity to 3 f of x dx. So minus infinity less than x less than 3. So this, from the definition of f of x, this can be written as integral minus infinity to 0 f of x dx plus 0 to 3 f of x dx. So in this interval, f of x is 0, so this vanishes. So we are left with the second integral. In this interval 0 to 3, f of x is 1 by 3 e power minus x by 3. Okay. So therefore, p of x less than 3 is equal to 1 by 3 constant can be written outside the integral into integral 0 to 3 e power minus x by 3 dx. So integrating e power minus x by 3, we get the 1 by 3 outside the bracket e power minus x by 3 divided by minus 1 by 3 evaluated at 0 and 3. So this is equal to, so 3 can cancel, taking minus sign outside for our convenience. So minus of e power minus x by 3 evaluated at 0 and 3. So when we put the limits, when upper limit is substituted, e power minus 3 by 3 is minus 1. So minus of e power minus 1 minus the lower limit e power 0 is 1. If we take minus sign inside or multiply by minus sign, we get plus 1 minus e power minus 1, that is 1 by e. So when we simplify using the calculator, when we calculate this using calculator, we've obtained the numerical value 0.6321. Therefore, probability of x less than 3 is equal to 0.6321. Second question. If x is an exponential variate with mean 5, evaluate probability of 0 less than x less than 1 and probability of minus infinity less than x less than 10. So it is given that mean is 5. So let us write down the probability density function of exponential distribution, that is f of x is equal to alpha e power minus alpha x greater than or equal to 0 and elsewhere 0, alpha is positive. So mean is given to be, if you know the mean is 1 by alpha, and it is given that mean is equal to 5, therefore 5 is equal to 1 by alpha or alpha is equal to 1 by 5. So therefore, substituting for alpha in the definition of f of x, we obtain the probability density function f of x is equal to 1 by 5 e power minus 1 by 5 into x, that is minus x by 5 for x greater than or equal to 0 and 0 elsewhere. The first problem, probability of 0 less than x less than 1 is equal to integral 0 to 1 fx dx. So in this integral, interval 0 to 1, f of x is 1 by 5 e power minus x by 5. So integral 0 to 1, 1 by 5 e power minus x by 5 dx. So when we integrate this, we obtain 1 by 5 integration of e power minus x by 5, e power minus x by 5 divided by minus 1 by 5 evaluated at 0 and 1. So we can cancel this 5 and taking minus sign outside, this can be conveniently written as minus e power minus x by 5 evaluated at 0 and 1. So when upper limit is substituted, so this is equal to minus, when x is 1, e power minus 1 by 5 minus when x is 0, e power 0 is 1. So if you multiply by minus side, we get plus 1 minus e power minus 1 by 5. If we calculate this using calculator, we obtain the numerical value 0.1812. So therefore, probability of 0 less than x less than 1 is equal to 0.1812. The second problem, probability of minus infinity less than x less than 10. So this is equal to minus infinity to 10 f of x dx. So by using the definition of f x, this can be written as this is equal to minus infinity to 0 f x dx plus 0 to 10 f of x dx. So in this interval, f of x is 0, so this integral vanishes. And in the interval 0 to 10, f of x is 1 by 5 e power minus x by 5. So therefore, probability of minus infinity less than x less than 10 is equal to the integral 0 to 10 1 by 5 e power minus x by 5 dx. So when we integrate this, this is equal to 1 by 5 is constant that can be removed outside into e power minus x by 5 divided by minus 1 by 5 evaluated at 0 and 10. When the limits are substituted, so this will become, this is equal to minus, so you can cancel out this 5 and taking the minus sign outside for our convenience. So this can be conveniently be written as minus e power minus x by 5 evaluated at 0 and 10. So this 5 is cancelled, this minus I have written outside. So this function e power minus x by 5 evaluated at 0 and 10 is equal to minus of, when x is 10, e power minus 10 by 5 minus 2 e power minus 2 minus, when x is 0, e power 0 is 1. So when we take minus n inside, this will become 1 minus e power minus 2 plus 1 minus e power minus 2. So using calculator, this is the value of this is 0.8646. therefore, probability of minus infinity less than x less than 10 is equal to 0.8646. Okay, third problem. The length of the telephone conversation in a booth has been an exponential distribution and found on an average to be 5 minutes. Find the probability that a random call made from this booth ends less than 5 minutes, between 5 and 10 minutes. The question is, the length of the telephone conversation in a booth has been exponentially distributed, or has been an exponential distribution and found on an average. So mean is given to be 5 minutes, average to be 5 minutes, so mean is 5 minutes. Find the probability that a random call made from this booth is ends less than 5 minutes. Probability that a random call made from this booth is between 5 and 10 minutes. So we need to calculate the probability that a random call made from this booth, that is probability that a call ends less than 5 minutes, and the probability that a random call is between 5 and 10 minutes. That means we need to calculate for the question number 1, probability of x less than 5, and for in the second case we have to find the probability of 5 less than x less than 10. Okay. So let us write the first probability density function of exponential distribution, that is f of x is equal to alpha into e power minus alpha x for x greater than or equal to 0 and elsewhere 0 where alpha is positive. So mean is 1 by alpha, we know this. A mean is given to be 5, so 5 is equal to 1 by alpha, or alpha is equal to 1 by 5. So therefore, substituting the value of alpha in f of x, we've obtained f of x is equal to 1 by 5 e power minus x by 5 for x greater than or equal to 0 and 0 elsewhere. Okay, as I told you, for the question number 1, we need to calculate the probability that a random call ends less than 5 minutes. That means we have to find the probability of x less than 5. Probability that a random call ends less than 5 minutes means we have to calculate the probability of x less than 5. So therefore, probability of x less than 5 is equal to, you can directly write 0 to 5. Actually, this is minus infinity to plus 5, and using the definition of f of x, this is written as minus infinity to 0 f of x dx plus 0 to 5 f of x dx. In the interval minus infinity to 0 f of x is equal to 0. So we are left with the second integral 0 to 5 f of x dx. With that understanding, we can directly write probability of x less than 5 is equal to integral 0 to 5 f of x dx. So in this interval, f of x is 1 by 5 e power minus x by 5. So therefore, this is equal to integral 0 to 5 1 by 5 e power minus x by 5 dx. So integrating this with respect to x from 0 to 5, we get 1 by 5 outside the bracket. Integration of e power minus x by 5, e power minus x by 5 divided by minus 1 by 5, evaluated at 0 and 5. So this 5, 5 you can cancel, taking minus sign outside for our convenience is equal to minus of e power minus x by 5 evaluated at 0 and 5. So this is equal to when upper limit is substituted, when x is 5, minus 5 by 5 minus 1. So minus of e power minus 1 minus e power 0, that is minus 1. E power 0 is 1, so minus 1. Taking minus sign inside, we get plus 1 minus e power minus 1. So when we calculate this, you obtain the numerical value 0.6321. That means the probability that a random call ends less than 5 minutes is equal to 0.6321. Similarly, for the second question, the probability that a random call is between 5 and 10 minutes is probability of 5 less than x less than 10. So we need to calculate the probability of 5 less than x less than 10. So this is equal to integral 5 to 10 f of x dx. So in this interval 5 to 10, f of x is 1 by 5 e power minus x by 5. So therefore, this is equal to integral 5 to 10 1 by 5 e power minus x by 5 dx. So integrating this with respect to x from 5 to 10, we obtain 1 by 5 outside the bracket e power minus x by 5 divided by minus 1 by 5. That is integration of e power minus x by 5 is e power minus x by 5 divided by minus 1 by 5, evaluated at 5 and 10. So cancelling this 5 and taking minus sign outside, we get minus of e power minus x by 5 evaluated at 5 and 10. So when we apply the upper limit, e power minus 10 by 5 is e power minus 2, minus when x is 5, e power minus 5 by 5 is e power minus 1, so minus e power minus 1. So when we take minus sign inside, this will be e power minus 1 minus e power minus 2. When we calculate using calculator, you obtain the numerical value, that is the probability of 5 less than x less than 10. That is the probability of a random call is between 5 and 10 minutes is equal to 0.2325. Fourth question. In a certain city, the duration of the shower is exponentially distributed with mean 5 minutes. What is the probability that a shower will last for 10 minutes or more, less than 10 minutes, and between 10 to 12 minutes? So it is given that the duration of the shower is exponentially distributed, the random variable duration of the shower exponentially distributed with mean 5. So it is given that 1 by alpha is equal to 5, that is mean is 5. We need to calculate the probability that a shower will last for 10 minutes or more, that is the probability of x greater than or equal to 10. Then the probability that a shower will last for less than 10 minutes is probability of x less than 10, and the probability that a shower will be between 10 to 12 minutes is the probability of 10 less than x less than 12. So we need to calculate these probabilities. So first let us write down the probability density function of exponential distribution. That is f of x is equal to alpha e power minus alpha x for x greater than or equal to 0 and 0 elsewhere where alpha is positive. So we know that mean is equal to 1 by alpha, but mean is given to be 5. Mean is given to be 5 minutes. So 5 is equal to 1 by alpha, or alpha is equal to 1 by 5. So substituting the value of alpha in our f of x, we get f of x is equal to 1 by 5 e power minus x by 5, x greater than or equal to 0, 0 elsewhere. Question number 1. The probability that a shower will last for 10 minutes or more is probability of x greater than or equal to 10. 10 minutes or more. So greater than or equal to 10. So therefore, probability of x greater than or equal to 10 is nothing but integral 10 to infinity, that is 10 less than or equal to x less than infinity, 10 to infinity f of x dx. So in this interval 10 to infinity, fx is 1 by 5, fx is 1 by 5 e power minus x by 5. So integrating e power minus x by 5 with respect to x from 10 to infinity, we obtain 1 by 5 outside the bracket into e power minus x by 5 divided by minus 1 by 5 evaluated at 10 and infinity. So cancelling this 5 and 5, taking minus sign outside for our convenience, so this is equal to minus of e power minus x by 5 evaluated at 10 and infinity. So this minus 5 and 5 you can cancel, minus sign you can take outside. So e power minus x by 5 evaluated at 10 and infinity, 10 and infinity. So this is equal to minus of, when x is made infinity, e power minus infinity is 0, minus when x is 10, minus 10 by 5, minus 2, e power minus 2. When we take minus and inside, this will become e power plus e power minus 2. Its value is 0.1353 up to 4 decimals. So therefore, probability that a shower will last for 10 minutes or more is equal to 0.1353. The second question, the probability that a shower will last for less than 10 minutes is probability of x less than 10. So therefore, probability of x less than 10 is equal to 0 to 10 fx dx. Actually, this is minus infinity less than x less than 10. So integral, this is equal to minus infinity to 10, and that should be written as minus infinity to 0 plus 0 to 10. In the interval minus infinity to 0, fx is 0. So we are left with integral 0 to 10 f of x dx. In this interval 0 to 10, f of x is 1 by 5 e power minus x by 5. So therefore, probability of x less than 10 is equal to integral 0 to 10 1 by 5 e power minus x by 5 dx. So integrating e power minus x by 5 with respect to x from 0 to 10, so we obtain 1 by 5 outside the bracket, e power minus x by 5 divided by a is minus 1 by 5, minus 1 by 5 evaluated at 0 and 10. So cancelling this 5 and taking minus sign outside, so this is equal to minus of e power minus x by 5 evaluated at 0 and 10 is equal to minus when x is 10, when upper limit is substituted, x is 10, you get minus 2, minus 10 by 5, minus 2. So e power minus 2, minus when x is 0, e power 0 is 1, so you get plus 1. If you take minus sign inside, this will become plus 1 minus e power minus 2. Using calculator, the value of this is 0.8646. So therefore, probability that a shower will last for less than 10 minutes is equal to 0.8646. Next question. Probability that a shower between 10 and 12 minutes is probability of 10 less than x less than 12. Probability that a shower between 10 and 12 minutes is probability of 10 less than x less than 12, as I told earlier. Therefore, we need to calculate this probability. So this probability of 10 less than x less than 12 is equal to 10 to 12 f of x dx. This is equal to 10 to 12 f of x is, in this interval f of x is 1 by 5 e power minus x by 5. So integrating e power minus x by 5 with respect to x from 10 to 12, So taking 1 by 5 outside, 1 by 5 outside, so this is equal to 1 by 5 into bracket, outside the bracket, into e power minus x by 5, integration of e power minus x by 5, e power minus x by 5, divided by minus 1 by 5, evaluated at 10 and 12. So this is equal to, so cancel out this 5 and taking minus n outside, minus e power minus x by 5, evaluated at 10 and 12. So this is equal to, when x is 12, e power minus 12 by 5, minus when x is 10, minus 10 by 5, that is minus 2, e power minus 2. So taking minus n inside, we obtain e power minus 2 minus e power minus 12 by 5. So using calculator, this value is 0.0446. Therefore, probability that a shower is between 10 and 12 minutes is 0.0446. Next question. The sales per day in a shop are exponentially distributed with average sale amounting to rupees 100 and net profit is 8%. Find the probability that the net profit exceeds rupees 30 on two consecutive days. The question is, the sales per day in a shop are exponentially distributed with average. Average means mean. So mean sale amounting to rupees 100. That is, mean is given to be 100 and net profit 8%. Find the probability that the net profit exceeds rupees 30 on two consecutive days. Okay, let us write down the probability density function of exponential distribution, that is f of x is equal to alpha e power minus alpha x for x greater than or equal to 0, 0 elsewhere, where alpha is positive. So mean, we know the mean is 1 by alpha for exponential distribution, but mean is given to be 100, so 100 is equal to 1 by alpha, so therefore alpha is 1 by 100 or 0.01. So therefore f of x is equal to, so substituting the value of alpha in f of x, we obtain f of x is equal to alpha is 0.01 e power minus 0.01 x for x greater than or equal to 0 and elsewhere 0. So first we have to find out the sales or amount for which 8% is the profit. Let us first find out the sales or amount for which the profit is rupees 30 at the rate of 8%. That means, if I assume that A be the sales for which 8% is the profit, then I get the equation 8% of A is equal to 30. 8% of A is equal to 30. That means A into 8% is 8 by 100 is equal to 30. So therefore, A is 30 into 100 divided by 8. So this is 3000 by 8. This will simplify. This is simplified to 375. So A is 375 for which rupees 30 is the profit at the rate 8%. 8% of A is rupees 30. Okay. The probability of profit exceeds rupees 30 if sales exceeds rupees 375. That means profit will be more only when sales will be more. So it is as good as finding the probability of sales exceeding rupees 375. So therefore, let us calculate the probability of x, that is sales greater than 375. Random variable x is greater than 375. This is equal to 1 minus probability of x, its complement. Complement of this is 1 minus probability of x less than or equal to 375. So this is equal to 1 minus, this is, okay, with that understanding, minus infinity to 0, f of x is equal to 0. So we can directly write this as 1 minus integral 0 to 375 of 0.01. That is, in this interval, f of x is 0.01 e power minus 0.01 x. So 0.01 e power minus 0.01 x dx. So integrating this with respect to x from 0 to 375, you obtain 1 minus 0.01, can write outside. Integration of e power minus 0.01 x is e power minus 0.01 x divided by minus 0.01 evaluated at 0 and 375. So cancelling 0.01 and this 0.01 and taking minus sign outside, this will be 1 plus e power minus 0.01 x evaluated at 0 and 375. So this is equal to 1 plus, when upper limit is substituted, we get e power minus 0.01 into 375 minus, when x is 0, e power 0 is 1, so minus 1, this minus 1 plus 1 will get cancelled. So this is equal to the numerical value 0.0235. So therefore, probability of x greater than 375 is 0.0235. So this is the probability that profit exceeds rupees 30 on a single day. So thus, the probability that profit exceeds rupees 30 on a single day is 0.0235. So therefore, probability that the net profit exceeds rupees 30 on two consecutive days is equal to 0.0235 into 0.0235, that is equal to 0.005. That is probability that the net profit exceeds rupees 30 on two consecutive days is equal to 0.0005. Next question. The mileage which car owner get with a certain kind of radial tire is a random variable having an exponential distribution with mean 40,000 km. Find the probabilities that one of these tires will last at least to 20,000 km and to at most 30,000 km. The question is, the mileage which car owner get with a certain kind of radial tire is a random variable having an exponential distribution with mean. So mean is given to be 40,000 km. We need to find the probabilities that one of these tires will last at least 20,000 km and at most 30,000 km. The probability that one of these tires will last at least 20,000 km is probability of x greater than or equal to, at least means greater than or equal to 20,000. The second question, the probability that one of these tires will last at most 30,000 km is probability of x less than or equal to x. Okay, so given mean is 40,000 km. So let us write down first the probability density function of exponential distribution, that is f of x is equal to alpha e power minus alpha x, x greater than or equal to 0 and elsewhere 0, where alpha is positive. We know that mean is equal to 1 by alpha, but mean is given to be 40,000. Mean is given to be 40,000. So 40,000 is equal to 1 by alpha, or alpha is 1 divided by 40,000. So substituting the value of alpha in our f of x, we get f of x is equal to 1 divided by 40,000 e power minus x by 40,000 for x greater than or equal to 0 and elsewhere 0. First problem, probability that one of these tires will last at least 20,000 km is probability of x greater than or equal to 20,000. So we need to calculate probability of x greater than or equal to 20,000. So this is equal to 1 minus its complement. Its complement is 1 minus probability of x less than 20,000. Therefore, this is equal to 1 minus integral 0 to 20,000 of, in this interval, f of x is 1 by 40,000 into e power minus x by 40,000. So 1 by 40,000 into e power minus x by 40,000 dx. So integrating this with respect to x from 0 to 20,000, we obtain. So 1 by 40,000 is a constant that can be removed. So 1 minus 1 by 40,000 into e power minus x by 40,000 divided by, so a is minus 1 by 40,000. So minus 1 by 40,000. So this is evaluated at 0 and 20,000. So this 40,000 and this 40,000, you can cancel 40,000 and this 40,000. Minus sign can be taken out, so that become plus 1 plus e power minus x by 40,000 evaluated at 0 and 20,000. So when we put the limits, so you get 1 plus e power minus 20,000 by 40,000 minus, when x is 0, e power 0 is 1, so plus 1 minus 1 will get cancelled. So this is e power minus 2 by 4 or e power minus half, that is equal to 0.6065. therefore, probability of x greater than or equal to 20,000, that means probability that one of these tires will lost for at least 20,000 kilometer is 0.6065. similarly, next question, the probability that one of these tires will last for at most 30,000 kilometer is probability of x less than or equal to 30,000. So we need to calculate probability of x less than or equal to 30,000. So this is equal to 0 to 30,000. In this interval, f of x is 1 by 40,000 e power minus x by 40,000. 1 by 40,000 into e power minus x by 40,000 dx. So integrating this with respect to x from 0 to 30,000, so 1 by 40,000 is constant, so that can be removed outside, can be written outside. So this is equal to integration of e power minus x by 40,000 is e power minus x by 40,000 divided by minus 1 by 40,000 evaluated at 0 and 30,000. So this 40,000, this 40,000 can cancelled, this minus can be removed outside. So minus of e power minus x by 40,000 evaluated at 0 and 30,000. So this is equal to minus of, when x is 30,000, so you get e power minus 30,000 by 40,000 minus, when x is 0, e power 0 is 1. So this is e power minus 3 by 4 minus 1. So if you take minus sign inside, this become plus 1 minus e power minus 3 by 4. So when we calculate this using calculator, we obtain the numerical value 0.5276. So therefore, probability of x less than or equal to 30,000 is 0.5276. In other words, the probability that one of these tires will last for at most 30,000 kilometer is equal to 0.5276. Next question. If x is exponentially distributed, prove that the probability that x exceeds its expected value is less than 0.5. If x is exponentially distributed, prove that the probability that x exceeds its expected value. Expected value means mean. The mean of exponential probability distribution is 1 by alpha. 1 by alpha. So that means we have to show that probability of x greater than expected value, that is 1 by alpha, is less than 0.5. Its numerical value, its probability is less than 0.5. So first let us write down the probability density function of exponential distribution. F of x, that is f of x is equal to alpha e power minus alpha x for x greater than or equal to 0. And elsewhere 0, alpha is positive. So we know that mean is equal to, mean of this exponential distribution is 1 by alpha. So we need to show that probability of x 1 by alpha, that is probability that x exceeds its expected value, that means probability of x exceeds, that is greater than 1 by alpha. We have to show that this probability is less than 0.5. So we shall show that. So therefore, probability of x greater than 1 by alpha is equal to 1 by alpha less than x less than infinity. So 1 by alpha to infinity, here f of x is alpha into e power minus alpha x dash. Directly you can write like this. So when we integrate the alpha into e power minus alpha x with respect to x from 1 by alpha to infinity, we obtain alpha is constant, so we can write outside into e power minus alpha x by minus alpha evaluated at 1 by alpha and infinity. So this is equal to alpha into, when x is made infinity, e power minus infinity is 0, 0 minus e power, when x is 1 by alpha, alpha into 1 by alpha, that is minus 1, e power minus 1 divided by minus alpha. When x is infinity, this is 0, minus when x is 1 by alpha, e power minus 1 by minus alpha. So minus into minus plus. So alpha will get cancelled. So you get e power minus 1. Its value is 0.3678. is less than 0.5. that means we have shown that probability of x exceeding probability that x exceeds its expected value is less than 0.5. probability of x exceeds its expected value is 0.3678, which is less than 0.5. Dear students, this completes the portions of module 3, that is probability distributions. In my classes, I have covered most of the previous question paper problems, including model question paper problems as well. I take this opportunity to once again thank the authorities of VTU for identifying me as one of the subject experts to deliver lectures in this prestigious eShikshana program 3. I also express my sincere thanks to our management and principal, RR Institute of Technology, for their encouragement and support for me to involved in this program. Dear students, for any inquiries, doubts, clarification of my classes, please contact me and I will be very happy to answer your questions. My address is